Hi guys, my name is Dr. Arohi Manyar and today we are going to study about public health dentistry. So the first chapter in that is epidemiology. So today we'll go about with the definition and the three different epidemiological studies. So what is the definition of epidemiology? So John M. Last was the person who gave us this definition. So it is the study of distribution and determinants. So I'll make it very easier for you to understand this. So just underline the points that I ask you to underline. The study of distribution and determinants of the health related states or events. So the distribution and the determination of the health related states or event means the disease or the condition that is occurring in the normal population. So what is the distribution and what are the factors that determine that distribution? So we have to study those factors, we have to study those determinants and the distribution of the conditions of the health related states or the events in a specific population, in not all population, in just a group of people or in a people of certain area. And the application of this study to control the health problem. So then we have to apply what we study to control the health problem. So we have to remember only 4-5 points in the definition. John M. Last gave this definition. It is the study of distribution and determinants of the health related states or events in a specific population and the application of this study to control the health related problems. Okay, so basically we have three studies in epidemiology which can help us to go about with all these processes or all these studies of health related events. So the three are descriptive, analytical and experimental. So today we are just going to go about with the descriptive. In the upcoming videos, we'll talk about analytical and experimental epidemiological studies. So in descriptive, there are 6 points that we have to learn so that we'll be able to write the answers. The first is define the population to be studied. So whenever you are trying to learn certain kind of questions, you have to learn it with a specific example. So here we'll talk about our newly COVID era, which has just passed by. And here we have to correlate the same with our situation. So first we have to define the population to be studied. So where will you do the COVID test? So we'll have a specific population on which we'll see about the symptoms, we'll see about what are the effects happening to those people, and then we'll make our logical explanations regarding that. So first we'll define the population, that the population in India are to be studied or in the population in America needs to be studied. After that we have to define the disease. So what is COVID? Nobody knew what the disease was or what the condition was. So then we have to define the disease. So the people who are suffering from fever or people who are suffering from cold, headache, cough, all those people are, that means we are defining the disease. We are defining what COVID is. So all those people who have certain symptoms need to be studied. So when we know the disease, after that we can know the population to be studied. So what should the disease be like? So whatever symptoms that we are looking for, it has to be precise and valid for every person who has COVID. So that is our second point, defining the disease to be studied. The third is describing the disease. So then we have to describe that why are we going to study this disease. So we have to describe its occurrence and its distribution. So how will we be able to describe that? The first is time, place and person. Though what is the time? So in which area or in which time zone did COVID occur? So from 2019 to 2020-21 was our COVID area. So it can be a short term distribution, it can be a long term distribution. Certain diseases are very long term, like plague and polio and all that condition. So those are very long. So the prevalence of that disease is quite for a couple of years of period of time, whereas certain diseases are very short lived, like if somebody has malaria or somebody has dengue. So that person will overcome that condition or that situation in a certain time frame. So that are short lived diseases, some are long lived diseases. So first is our time, second is place. So in which geographical condition or which places are these diseases being flourished or these diseases contaminating other people. And the third is person. So which group of people are contacting this disease? That is what we have to write in describing the disease. So people from lower socioeconomic background or people who are commuting a lot or people who are being in contact with other people a lot. So these kind of people who are working, who are going out of their houses. So these are the people who are getting or catching COVID. So that is how we describe the disease. After that we have to measure this disease. So is the disease a short lived or is the disease mild? Is the disease in the moderate stage or is it a severe condition? So then we have to study about its prevalence. So how will we measure the disease? Measurement of disease means, is it mild, moderate or severe? Some disease like cancer. Cancer can be of mild stage, which can be surgically removed. Cancer can be of a fourth grade or fourth stage, which cannot be removed or which cannot be treated. So people die in that cases. So those are the extreme level or the severe conditions of cancer. Similarly, even in COVID era, we also saw some patients came and they were having extreme COVID effects on them. So they were the people who were short-lived. They could not be treated or they could not be helped by the doctors. So how would we measure? We would measure the disease by the cross-sectional study, by the prevalence of the disease, how long the disease have prevailed and what are the symptoms that developed over time. And the last is the longitudinal study. So over a long period of time, what happened and what are the changes? Like in COVID, we had virus that were Delta and Omega and blah, blah, blah. So we had different viruses that were emerging. So that comes under our measurement of the disease. The fifth is comparing it with known indices. So the known indices are the RT-PCR test and the CT scan that we already knew that existed before the COVID came into our life. So RT-PCR was something that already existed in the labs. They were the tests that were usually not very regularly performed, but usually performed on people who were recommended. So then we compare those RT-PCR values, those CT scan values with our COVID situation or the people who are having COVID symptoms. And after that, after knowing all these things, all these deducting, all these conditions, symptoms, places, time and everything, then we formulate our etiological hypothesis. So what does this mean? Hypothesis means a supposition. So after knowing where this happened, how this happened, what happens, what are the symptoms, how to prevent, what are the effects for a long period of time. So gathering all those information, deducting a few, after that we'll know what is the etiology of COVID. So we didn't know when COVID came into our life, how did it happen or what happened during COVID. But after, when the scientists or when the scholars did all this research, did all this analysis, after that we were given a very simple definition of COVID, that these things happen. People are having fever, people are having cough, cold, headaches and all that. So this is basically why do we need to study epidemiology, because whenever a new disease or whenever a new condition comes into our lives, we need to know how did it come. So for the how or for the causation of the disease, we need to formulate an etiological hypothesis. So this is all about our descriptive study. We have to just remember this six basic points. If you are thorough with these 6 points, I'm damn sure you will be able to write any answer with any disease or any conditions that you get in the paper. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, I hope you like this video. Please hit the bell icon and subscribe to my channel for the upcoming notifications. Also, don't forget to comment in the comment section below about the topics that you want me to discuss later on. And to get in direct touch with me, you can also DM me on my Instagram ID, which I'll be putting in the description box below. Thanks for watching.